I'm sorry. Next question.
I just want to ask the Sheikh, I converted to Islam, and he said earlier that in the Quran it says to obey your parents. Well, I'm disobeying my parents, I converted. I'd just like to know if I'm sinning, and if I am, what do I do to make it right?
I take it you're concerned that you're disobeying your parents by converting, and what can you do to make it right? Is that your question? Okay, that takes the wisdom of Solomon, I think.
In the Quran, the solution to your problems is given. In the chapter I mentioned, Surah Maryam, chapter Mary. In that chapter, there is a story of Abraham. Abraham, he was a man of God. He had discovered the way to God, a right concept of God. But his father was an idol worshipper. And now you read the story. It says, and narrate in the book the story of Abraham. Innahu kana siddiqan nabiyya. He was a man of truth, a prophet. Is qala li abihi. He says, behold, he said to his father, Ya abati, O my father, لِمَ تَعْبُدُوا مَا لَا يَسْمَعُوا وَلَا يُبْصِرُوا وَلَا يُغْنِيَنْكَ شَيْعَا said, why do you worship that which can neither hear, nor see, nor profit you nothing? يَا أَبَتِي, O my father, إِنِّي كَجَّانِ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِكَ فَاتَّبِئْنِي أَهْدِكَ صِرَاطًا سَوِيًّا said, O my father, knowledge has come to me which has not reached you. So follow me and I will show you that way that is even and straight. Ya Abati, O my father. And again, Ya Abati, O my father. Four times every verse begins with, O my father, O my father, O my, with compassion and feeling for his father, trying to save him from hellfire. The father, his pagan arrogance, he says, Qala araghibun antan alihati ya Ibrahim. He says, does thou hate my gods, O Abraham? He says, get out of my sight for a good long while, otherwise I'll stone you to death. Now, the response of Abraham to that, and the commentary on that is to be found in this book, that how a dutiful son ought to reason and be compassionate towards his unbelieving parents. You love them, you respect them, you treat them well. The only thing when it comes to matters between you and God, they have no control. It's between your belief and unbelief, then you have to reject, on that respect, you reject their advice, their force of the persuasion, the pressure on you. You reject it. But even then, you treat them as your parents, your father and your mother. When it comes to religious matters, they do not come in between you and God. That is what the Quran says. I think you have this Quran. You have a Quran like this, by Yusuf Ali. You have a Quran, chapter 19, and you see the commentary, and he'll tell you the exact position that you must occupy. When it comes to faith, nobody comes in between you and God. Nobody. Not even your father or your mother. But you still love them and you respect them. That's what the Quran says.